Given the sequence 5, comma x, comma y, comma 625, for the first question, we're asked to find x and y such that the sequence is arithmetic. If the sequence is arithmetic, then successive terms have a common difference, d, or we can say that 5 plus d must equal x, x plus d must equal y, and y plus d must equal 625. Let's let the first term be a sub 0, and therefore a sub 0 is equal to 5, a sub 1 is equal to x, a sub 2 is equal to y, and a sub 3 is equal to 625. In order to determine x and y, given we have an arithmetic sequence, we need to determine the common difference d. Using a sub 0 and a sub 3, notice a sub 3 is equal to a sub 0 plus d plus d plus d, or a sub 0 plus 3d. Because we know a sub 3 and a sub 0, we can now set up this equation and solve for d. A sub 3 is equal to 625. A sub 0 is equal to 5, which gives us the equation 625 equals 5 plus 3d. And now to solve for d, we subtract 5 on both sides, which gives us 620 equals 3d. And then we divide both sides by 3. Simplifying, we have d equals 6/23. And 3 is not a factor of 620, and therefore we'll leave d as an improper fraction. And now let's go ahead and find x. Remember, x is equal to a sub 1. So a sub 1 is equal to x, which must equal 5 plus d, which gives us 5 plus 6/23. 5 is equal to 15/3, giving us 15/3 plus 6/23, which is equal to 635/3. 3 does not divide evenly into 635, and therefore we'll leave x as an improper fraction. And now let's determine a sub 2, which is y. A sub 2, which is equal to y, is equal to x plus d, where we know x is equal to 635/3, which gives us 635/3 plus d, which is 620/3, which is equal to 1,255/3. And again, this does not divide evenly. We'll leave y as an improper fraction. Now, if we want to check to make sure this is correct, what we can do is take the value of y and add d one more time to make sure we get 625. And let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to check our work. We'll take y, which is 1,255/3. And then we'll add d one more time to make sure we do get a sub 3, which is 625. So we have plus 620/3, which we can see is 625, verifying we found x and y correctly. And now let's look at the second part, where we're asked to find x and y such that the sequence is now geometric. If we have a geometric sequence, we have a common ratio r, where we can say 5 times r must equal x, x times r must equal y, and y times r must equal 625. So again, because we know a sub 3 and a sub 0, when we have a geometric sequence, we can say that a sub 3 is equal to a sub 0 times r times r times r times r cubed, which in our case gives us the equation 625 equals 5 times r cubed. And now we solve for r. The first step is to divide both sides by 5. Simplifying, we have r cubed equals 125. And now to solve for r, we take the cube root of both sides of the equation. The cube root of r cubed is r. The cube root of 125 is 5, since 5 cubed equals 125. And now that we know r, we can determine x and y. A sub 1 is equal to x, which is equal to a sub 0 times r, or 5 times r, which gives us 5 times 5, which is equal to 25. A sub 2 is equal to y, which is equal to a sub 1 times r, or x times r, which is 25 times 5, which equals 125. And if we do want to check this, we can verify that y times r, or 125 times 5, is 625, which we can see is correct. I hope you found this helpful.